Good morning. My name is Narendra Venkat Reddy. I am Global Product Manager for Trace Minerals, working in Trow Nutrition. Today's topic is gut health benefit of copper in broiler production. Disclaimer, please note that all product names and claims mentioned in this webinar are generic and can differ from your local situation. Please contact your local Selco or Trow Nutrition representative to discuss your needs and options. Today's agenda will look like this: antibiotic resistance risk, feed, form, and health approach, high copper levels and its effects, application and results with high levels of copper, take home message. Antibiotic resistant risk. According to WHO prediction, by 2050, is more people will die by common bacterial infection that is resistant to antibiotic than they will die of cancer. At present, cancer is number one cause for death in humans. There is a relevant, this is very relevant for us and next generation. So antimicrobial resistance is an emerging health, human health risk. So as you can see, there is a lot of deaths across different parts of the world, and also you can see an annual average antibiotic consumption per kg of animal produced from different species. And also one of the studies shows that from 2010 to 2030, there is 60% increase in the antibiotic usage in the livestock farming. So strategies need to be developed to reduce the use of antibiotics both in humans and animals. To sustainably improve poultry performance or reduce the need for antibiotics, we have to take many factors into account, like raw material management, feed safety, feed hygiene, biosecurity, water quality, and health management. So from Trow Nutrition point of view, we call it as an integrated approach, feed, form, and health management approach. So here we are going to talk today mainly on health management side, especially on IntelliBond copper, which is a copper product. Copper, we all know that it's a trace mineral and which will be used at both nutrition levels and also eye levels. When we talk about nutrition levels, the objective is here to give this metal to get into the bloodstream to meet the physiological needs of the animal, especially on tissue integrity, enzyme process, immune competency. When we talk about eye levels, we are talking around 125 to 250 ppm levels, which will be a factor of 10 to 12 compared to nutrition levels. So the objective here is not to get the metal into the bloodstream, but the objective is to get the metal into distal portion of the intestinal tract, where can microbiota can interact with this copper, and which will result in a better animal performance, especially on feed efficiency, growth rate, gut health. So there is nothing novel about copper. I just wanted to pop these news bits from different news journals which occurred over the years. So our industry has started also recognizing this benefit of copper, especially in the cow footpath, especially they use copper sulfate to have better antimicrobial effect. So coming to IntelliBond copper, especially from Trow Nutrition solution, which is having a very good physical and chemical properties. As you can see, the look and feel of the product is really good. And as it has highly spear opticized particles, which is essentially dust-free, non-reactive, non-hygroscopic, uniformly blending. And the chemical structure, if you talk about that, it has similar to covalent bonds, and it will release the metal less than 4 pH, and above 4 pH, it will be very stable. And it is in a crystalline form, and which will be embedded in the opticized particle, which will be around 150 to 300 micron size. Coming, talking about eye level of copper and its effects in the broiler production. So let's talk about initially with the in vitro data, how does it work? We all know that copper has both antibacterial, like especially bacteriostatic and also bactericidal effect. When we talk about copper at 100 ppm levels in the in vitro study, there is no reduction in the microbial count. But as we increase the copper levels in the in vitro studies, as you can see at 400 ppm to 600 ppm, there is a significant reduction in the microbial population, especially we have taken two different species of Salmonella species here, and also E. coli and Clostridium species. So in vivo study, we wanted to correlate also here, and at the same time, we wanted to see that how does the copper effect will help in the in vivo study. So in this study, this is a classing study which was done in the US, and we fed the animal with 150 ppm levels of copper. And then after 21 days, we collected the sample from different parts of the intestine. Then we saw there is an average 375 ppm in the lower GAT when we fed 150 ppm in the feed. So which is equivalent to 1 ppm of copper you're feeding in the feed, and which will result in 2.5 ppm in the lower GA tract. So as you can remember my previous slide, where you're seeing a significant reduction in the microbial population at 600 ppm levels, for which we need to feed 240 ppm in the feed. So just correlate the in vitro study now with the in vivo study here. For example, if you feed 10 ppm as a nutrition levels in the feed, so do you see any results in the microbial reduction? No, because as you can see, we can correlate 10 ppm in the feed is equal to 25 ppm in the lower GAT. So that's why you don't see any results there. And when you increase from 10 to 125 ppm levels, where it will be almost equivalent to, you can see close to 400 ppm. So where you can see a significant improvement, significant reduction in the microbial population. And when you increase that to 250 ppm levels in the feed, then you will have 600 ppm effect in the in vitro, which we have seen. So this is also, we want to correlate, and also we did a study there, and here also in this study, we fed 150 ppm of copper, and especially one of the treatment, there are three treatments here. One treatment, there is nutrition levels of copper were fed, another treatment, copper sulfate was fed at 150 ppm levels, and another treatment we fed with 150 ppm levels of copper from IntelliBond copper. Copper sulfate, there is only, you can see 53% reduction in the E. coli counts, but if we can see there IntelliBond copper, there is 69% reduction, which is better compared to copper sulfate. And also you can see Clostridium perfringens, only 12% reduction in the Clostridium perfringens when fed with copper sulfate, and almost 22% reduction in the count in the Clostridium perfringens when we fed with IntelliBond copper. So this shows us less pathogenic bacteria. That means less bacteria to steal nutrients, which means better performance. So we want to also compare at the same time application, especially in the field conditions. We want to see that results, how it has worked in different studies, comparing that IntelliBond copper with copper sulfate, and also IntelliBond copper with AGP, and IntelliBond copper during a challenge conditions like necrotic enteritis. So here we all know that copper sulfate is a very cheap product, but when you use that product, it also costs your company. Why? Because we all know that copper sulfate is highly reactive, as you can see, and also it has very bad physical properties, and also because of its ionic nature, it also gets interacting with other nutritional, anti-nutritional factors, especially phytate, fats, vitamins, and amino acids. And copper also has a high tolerance. Because of that, you can see because of that, you can see lower feed intake. And again, IntelliBond copper, when we're comparing with copper sulfate at 125 ppm levels, where you can see 4.7 points improvement in the FCR from 7 different studies across the US. There is a direct evidence that replacing 125 ppm of copper from copper sulfate with copper from IntelliBond copper results in Ebert birds, better FCR. And this is the one which can show us we can easily replace copper sulfate with good economic returns with little upfront cost. And again, we want to compare your IntelliBond copper with AGP, especially BMD. And this study also, we can see we have 10 replications or 10 treatments where we can talk about one treatment one, there is no AGP or there is no copper used. So, and again, first five treatments, there is only copper program. And next five treatments, we have combined AGP with copper programs. So let's compare now with treatment one and treatment six. Treatment one is there is no copper used, no AGP used. Treatment six, there is AGP is used, and you can see improvement in the body weight. And let's compare now with the graded program of copper, especially first 14 days, we used 200 ppm of copper. 14 to 28 days, we used 150 ppm of copper. And 28 to 49 days, we used 125 ppm of copper. And treatment six, only 50 ppm of AGP is used. So when we compare these two groups, we can see a improvement in the body weight in the copper program compared to AGP program. And again, if you see here, treatment six has, you can see only 50 ppm of copper used, and treatment 10, the 50 ppm of copper, 50 ppm of BMD is used. And again, combine that with IntelliBond copper graded program. So then we can see a significant improvement in the body weight compared to only AGP group. So this shows that whenever we use copper, it gives added benefit for the animals, especially during challenging conditions. And also we want to replace AGP programs with our IntelliBond copper. And this also same here you can see there is a, when we do the FCR also, it also works in same way. Treatment one, there is no AGP or no copper. Treatment six, there is a AGP at 50 ppm. You can see improvement in the FCRs. And treatment five, where graded copper program, treatment six, the AGP program. So where you can see the graded program has performed better compared to the AGP program, which you can see 8 points improvements in the FCR. And again, if you compare AGP program with AGP program plus the graded copper program, then you can see 11 points improvement in the FCR. So, and also again, we want to compare your IntelliBond copper during necrotic enteritis challenge. We also seen, we have used around 200 to 275 ppm levels, and from six different studies from the US. So in these studies where we have seen 2.6 points improvement in the body weight, and also a good improvement in the FCR and both body weights. Again, we have seen less lesion scores and lower mortality. IntelliBond copper at high levels is very effective on non-antibiotic tool to combat necrotic enteritis. So there are a lot of quotes and published literatures available in the public domain. You can refer these literatures for your kind information to get more knowledge on this. So take home message, IntelliBond copper has proven its efficacy in both in vitro and in vivo trials. And IntelliBond copper versus copper sulfate is cheap but costs your company. IntelliBond copper outperforms copper sulfate in all the trials consistently with good economic returns. IntelliBond copper versus AGP has less cost, more rewards compared to AGPs with better performance. IntelliBond copper during necrotic enteritis challenge, better growth rate, FCR and lesion scores. So thank you for your attention and thank you for listening.
Thank you.